Right, we're given that cosine theta is equal to negative 1, and we have to figure out the rest. So right here, let's see, cosine theta, we know on the xy plane, this is x over r, right? And we know that r is always positive, and you see right here we have negative 1. We should look at this as a fraction, but r is always positive. So let's look at this as negative 1 on the top over positive 1. Because once we have this, we can say, let's go ahead and take x equals to negative 1 and r equals to positive 1. And of course, you can also say, I could have looked at this as negative 7 over positive 7. I still end up with negative 1, right? But use the simplest number right here, OK? So in fact, here, I can only come up with one picture, you'll see. Because right here, I know x is equal to negative 1. And if r is equal to 1, this means I have to go from the origin and travel to x being negative 1. It's only a straight line. I can only go from here to here, r is equal to 1, right? So you see, the angle here, in fact, a quadrantal angle, it is on the x-axis. But anyways, the deal right here is that you have to know, OK, x is equal to negative 1. And the y has to be 0. And the r is 1. These are the values that we are going to use. OK? So this is right here, what's the point? Negative 1, 0. And now we can finish this. Sine theta, this is equal to y over r, which is 0 over 1, right? Which is 0. Cosine theta, this is x over r, negative 1 over 1. So let me put this down. Negative 1 over 1, which is negative 1. Tangent theta, OK, y over x, right? So let me just write this down. Y over x, 0 over negative 1. And I can say this is 0. All right, cosecant theta is 1 over 0. But this is bad, so I will say this is undefined. Cannot have a 0 in the denominator. And then secant theta is technically 1 over negative 1. But doesn't really matter because I still end up with negative 1. Cotangent theta, it will be negative 1 over 0. Well, this is also bad because we have the 0 in the denominator. So put down undefined. And this is it.